When measuring features in FME, the most common question is, what unit of measurement should I use? Because FME always measures units using the current coordinate system, you need a good understanding of what coordinate system is being used and what spatial properties it preserves. In this tutorial, we will look at how to apply coordinate systems in FME, how to measure the area of neighborhoods in a city to get the required units, and how to minimize distortion. Before we begin, let's quickly review the data in the FME Data Inspector. The data for this tutorial is stored in Google KML format, where each polygon represents a different neighborhood in the city of Vancouver. We see that the data is currently stored in LL84 format, a latitude-longitude coordinate system. Let's open a new FME workspace and add a Google KML reader. Use the attached dataset found on the corresponding FME knowledge base tutorial. When prompted, select only the neighborhoods layer. Add an area calculator transformer to the workspace and connect it to the reader feature type. Because the neighborhoods layer is currently projected into a lat-long coordinate space, the transformer will calculate the area of each polygon in decimal degrees. So let's add a reprojector transformer to the canvas. By using the reprojector, we can bring our data into a coordinate space that will calculate area. Open the parameters and set the destination coordinate system to Canada Elbers. Canada Elbers is a coordinate system based on an equal area projection and can be used to calculate measures in square meters. With this coordinate system, we will get results that are close to the correct size. Let's continue by adding a second reprojector and again connect it to the reader so that we can compare the different coordinate systems available in FME. Open the parameters and set the destination coordinate system to ASMEA. ASMEA is an equal area coordinate system in FME that is dynamic, meaning each feature gets its own coordinate system with origin lines based on that feature. ASMEA minimizes distortion as much as possible and will calculate areas that are very close to the correct size. Add two area calculator transformers and connect them to the reprojectors. Now let's place a coordinate system extractor on the canvas. This transformer will record the coordinate system being used as an attribute. This is something that will help us to differentiate the results when we run this translation. Connect all three area calculators to the coordinate system extractor. Finally, add a fourth reprojector transformer. Set its parameters to LL84. This step is important because quite often you will want to reproject from LL84 to a coordinate system based on meters. But after the measurement calculation, you will want the data back in its original LL84 format. Add an inspector transformer after the final reprojector transformer. Now run the translation. Let's review the results in the FME Data Inspector. You can see that LL84 measures area in decimal degrees, while the other two results are measured in square meters and appear very similar. The slight differences between the two are because Canada Elbers has a central origin, whereas the dynamic ASMEA coordinate system calculates the origin for each different feature. This means that the ASMEA result is more reliable when calculating area, as it introduces less distortion.